Is it possible to communicate with the dead? Of course it is. With God, all things are possible. The Bible even mentions a case of a living human being who made contact with the spirit of a person who was physically dead. King Saul went to the witch of Endor to try and reach Samuel when he was in need of counsel. I have often stood near that little village of Endor, which is even now in the land of Israel, and I have thought of the terrible, terrible experience that Saul had as a result of his consorting with the witch of Endor. Samuel actually did appear because God caused it, not because of the witch. The witch of Endor was terrified, for she had not expected this manifestation. She had anticipated the usual impersonation or ectoplasmic reproduction by her familiar spirit, the demonic spirit with whom she worked. The tragic result of this seance should be a warning to all. Saul was condemned, the kingdom lost. His life wrested from him in an awful defeat for Israel. The writer of Chronicles explains that the reason Saul died was because he transgressed against the word of God and also for asking the counsel of one that had a familiar spirit to inquire of it. Chapter 10, verse 13. God clearly tells us that the living should not seek to the dead, nor to those that have familiar spirits, that is, mediums who consort with dark spirit beings who are familiar with the life history of human persons and can impersonate the dead. Rather, we are to seek God for guidance directly through prayer, and we must read the Word of God for counsel. See Isaiah chapter 8, verse 19. Isaiah also records, "Woe to the rebellious children, saith the Lord, that take counsel, but not of me." Isaiah chapter 30, verse 1.